मूवी का नाम है व्हाइट शर्ट एंड एवरीबॉडी इज प्रमोटिंग वेरी करेक्टली व्हाइट शर्ट क्या है थोड़ा सा ब्रीफ हो जाए व्हाट इज इट ऑल अबाउट
सो बेसिकली इट्स अबाउट वानी एंड अवीक वानी इज प्लेड बाय कृतिका अवीक इज प्लेड बाय कुणाल एंड इट्स अ कपल एंड हाउ व्हेन थिंग्स स्टार्ट टू फॉल अपार्ट दिस वन व्हाइट शर्ट इज होल्डिंग देम टुगेदर हाउ इट्स होल्डिंग देम टुगेदर व्हाट डज इट डू फॉर दैट यू हैव टू वॉच द फिल्म
Okay, Kunal, what was the first action, the moment the maker of this film approached you for the role, and what was the director's dream for you?
Well, you know, I actually really liked the story when I heard it, simply because, you know, I think the sort of intimate romantic drama that it is, it's the sort of film that you don't get to see anymore. And especially with short films and stuff, I think a lot of people that are making short films are constantly trying to be clever and, you know, trying to have a twist in the end or surprise or, you know, coming up with stories that are clever, which is also nice. But what I liked about this was that it was a straightforward, intimate, romantic drama, the sort of which I had not seen in a short film for sure.
Okay, Kritika, what was your reaction? And
I think quite similar. I also thought it was very simple yet beautiful, and there is a bit of like relatability. I think everybody has felt these emotions in life, and yeah, you know, there are not too many simple stories said straight these days. So this is one of them. And yeah, I really liked it when I heard it. And then I got to know that he's a part of it, and it just sort of fell in place, and yeah.
I had my doubts about the director though.
How do you relate to the character which you played in White Collar?
Well, you know, I think like she was saying, both the characters are really relatable. Actually, all three of them are really relatable. I think, you know, when you're in a relationship and you break up, you hold on to little things,
yeah.
Things that keep you connected to each other, which is the white shirt in this instance. And I think we've all been through that. You know, sometimes you're heartbroken, but you want to still reach out to the person, and you reach out for varied excuses. You make excuses about why you're calling the person, because you want to hear the person's voice again. You want to feel connected to them again. So here the white shirt becomes, you know, an instrument for them to be connected. So it was very relatable, and I think that's what's nice about the story, that it is simple, it is intimate, but it's also very, very, I think everybody out there will relate to the story.
I have a question for Sumit. Since you directed the film, can you tell us a little bit about the platform and, you know, how you got this opportunity, a little bit about that?
So see, I made the film because I really wanted to tell the story, because this was a story that was really close to my heart. So I told the story, I made this film with Kunal and Kritika, and then I was looking for a platform which is, you know, a platform which can really present my short film in a very perfect way.
Mm-hmm.
So that's when I really approached this Royal Stag Ballet Select Large Short Films platform, because I was always looking for, okay, this platform was constantly giving opportunities to short filmmakers and also known filmmakers to, you know, tell their stories in a very unique way. Because usually short films get lost in the crowd, and this platform is really helping them to really reach out to people.
Right.
So yeah, I approached this and here we are.
अच्छा, इसके अलावा आप दोनों से जानना चाहूँगा, आपने बड़े पर्दे पर काम किया है, आपने छोटे पर्दे पर काम किया है, तो शॉर्ट फिल्म करना कितना डिफिकल्ट रहा और कैसा एक्सपीरियंस रहा, अगर इस बारे में कुछ बताना चाहे, क्योंकि कम टाइम में बहुत कुछ एक्सप्लोर करना पड़ता है शॉर्ट फिल्म में,
जी,
तो
जी,
कैसा एक्सपीरियंस रहा?
जी, आई थिंक वो सबसे ज़्यादा चैलेंजिंग राइटर और डायरेक्टर के लिए होता है, क्योंकि आप अपनी बात कहने की कोशिश करें लेकिन आपके पास समय बहुत कम है. मुझे लगता है एक्टर के तौर पर मेरे लिए कोई फ़र्क नहीं है, चाहे मैं छोटे पर्दे पर कर रहा हूँ या बड़े पर्दे पे, या शॉर्ट फिल्म कर रहा हूँ या थिएटर कर रहा हूँ, अप्रोच हमेशा सेम रहता है. और चाहे वो कैरेक्टर हो, चाहे आप जो सीन्स कर रहे हो, उसका अप्रोच हमेशा सिमिलर रहता है. तो आई थिंक व्हाट इज़ रियली चैलेंजिंग अबाउट शॉर्ट फिल्म्स इज एक्चुअली फॉर द राइटर एंड डायरेक्टर, बिकॉज यू ट्राइंग टू से सो मच, बट यू ट्राइंग टू से इट इन सच अ शॉर्ट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. एंड आई हैव टू से दैट रॉयल स्टैग लार्ज शॉर्ट फिल्म्स इज अ फैंटास्टिक प्लेटफॉर्म, बिकॉज आई हैव सीन सच ग्रेट वर्क कम ऑन इट. And I love the way they've promoted the films as well, and they've really pushed short films, which is, you know, it's almost become like a small little parallel industry of its own.
For
short films, for actors that want to try something new, the directors that want to tell new stories. So I think it's an amazing platform.
Okay, so please continue.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
Yeah,
Kritika. No, like he said, it was fairly, I think it was easy because Sumit made it really easy. It was written so well, and you know, and then we did a couple of readings,
right.
And Kunal's great to work with, so it was all very easy. I think we're all easygoing people, so it happened quite smoothly, and yeah, even the shoot was very
smooth.
Yeah.
आप से जानना
चाहूँगा. So no hiccups.
मैम आपसे जानना चाहूँगा, हाल ही में एक्ट्रेस मलयालम एक्ट्रेस मोलेस्टेड हुआ मूविंग कार में, तो आप कैसे देखते हैं इस पूरी घटना को?
इस वक्त हम इस फिल्म के बारे में बात
करते हैं। ओके, सो द वे शॉर्ट फिल्म्स आर गोइंग अहेड, नो, फॉर एग्जांपल वी हैव सीन चटनी इन फिल्म्स
राइट, सेम प्लेटफॉर्म
डू यू थिंक इट्स अ लॉन्ग वे टू गो एंड पीपल स्टार्टेड अप्रिशिएटिंग इवन अ प्लेटफॉर्म लाइक फिल्मफेयर ओवर?
या डेफिनेटली, सी फिल्मफेयर नाउ हैज अ कैटेगरी फॉर शॉर्ट फिल्म स्पेसिफिकली. It means that people are taking it seriously now. The short film is not just, you know, the thing that people used to make for their own consumption. Now it has become a medium in itself where people are telling stories in a short film format. And the thing is, people are consuming so much of media these days. So people need good stories even in short formats. When you're traveling, you know, you need that 20 minutes of good storytelling. And it's not about 20 minutes of just watching something. You need to have, people want quality content. That's why people, filmmakers like Sujoy Ghosh, who made Hilly of the same platform, people are doing so much, you know, because filmmakers are coming out, Sujoy Ghosh, Neeraj Pandey made Ouch, because short film itself is a strong medium now, it's a strong format now, where you can tell a story which you can't tell in a feature film, because for a feature film you need a broader story. But sometimes you come up with stories which are not that broad, but yet they are stories worth telling. So what do you do with that? You keep it in the folder which you never make, or you make a short film out of it. That's what I think short films are becoming about. You tell your stories equally in a equally passionate way as you do a feature film, but yet it's a short film.
Okay, Kritika, do you know you are there in the industry for a long time, you know, on the small screen. Now you are coming on the short film. Are you eyeing Bollywood a big screen too?
I don't look at it like that actually. I want to do all mediums. I want to do everything. So I'll act. If I like the project, I'll do whatever it is. And this is not my first short film I've done two before. And I really like this format, like he said. It's very interesting. And it's really about the story. And the format and everything is, you know, the director's call. For me, whether it's TV or it's web or it's a short film, if I like the story and if I want to be a part of it, I'll do it. So I don't look at it like films and TV. I want to do everything. I'm greedy.
Kunal, while working on the project, what are the things which touch you a lot, you know? You feel like, yeah,
sorry
yeah,
about this, yeah. One second.
It's okay.
Yeah, sorry.
क्या छू गया आपको, यू नो, व्हाइल वर्क, एक एक्टर खुद भी रियलाइज करता है कि हाँ यार ये होता है, ये हुआ है, या मैं रिलेट कर पा रहा हूँ इससे, या मैं,
हाँ, मुझे लगता है सबसे ज्यादा जरूरी बात यही है, मैंने जैसे कह रहा था कि रिलेटेबिलिटी और एक अच्छी रोमांटिक पिक्चर, लेकिन रोमांटिक मतलब इन नॉट अ टिपिकल वे, इन अ सॉर्ट ऑफ अ टिपिकल वे. और दूसरा, जो कैरेक्टर्स थे मुझे बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग लगे, बहुत रिलेटेबल लगे. सिचुएशंस ऐसी थी कि हम सब उन सिचुएशन से गुजर चुके हैं, इस तरह की सिचुएशन से, और इस तरह कभी कभार रिएक्ट भी किया हमने. तो आई फाउंड इट वेरी रिलेटेबल, एंड लाइक आई सेड अर्लियर इज दैट आई जस्ट फाउंड इट वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ऑल द अदर शॉर्ट फिल्म्स दैट वर आउट देयर. आई फेल्ट लाइक इट वॉज नॉट अ फिल्म दैट वॉज trying to be smart. I felt that in fact it was a film that had a lot of heart, which I think made it special.
Okay, Kunal, apart from what's there in the pipeline, which are the projects that you're working on?
Well, I just have a film that's up for release. It's called Veeram, the Malayalam film. We shot in three languages. The Malayalam version is up for release this Friday. The Hindi and English will release somewhere around the end of March. And I've also finished a film with Tigmanchu Dhulia. It's called Ragdesh. It's based on the Indian National Army. That should release at some point this year as well.
Okay, on a very positive note, अगर मैं कुनाल की बात करता हूँ तो रंगदे बसंती का जिक्र कभी भी जाएगा नहीं. रंगदे बसंती असलम पहचान रही है कुनाल.
जी.
क्या आप मानते हैं कहीं एज एन एक्टर की जो पोटेंशियल एज एन एक्टर आपके अंदर है, अभी भी वो ड्यू है, बहुत कुछ दे सकते हैं जो नो रिकग्नाइज नहीं करा गया है इंडस्ट्री?
जी, वो तो मुझे लगता है हर एक्टर को लगता है कि मुझे जिस तरह का काम मिलना चाहिए नहीं मिला है. मुझे ऐसा लगता था, लेकिन मुझे लगता है कि अब बदल रहा है. द फिल्म्स दैट हैव डन इन द लास्ट ईयर, चाहे वो डियर जिंदगी हो, चाहे वीरम हो, चाहे रागदेश हो, जो सारे कैरेक्टर्स थे एक दूसरे से बहुत अलग थे, और बहुत अच्छे फिल्म मेकर्स के साथ काम किया है. तो मुझे लगता है कि वो बदल रहा है. एक समय था रंगदे बसंती के बाद और आजा नचले और सब जो पिक्चरें आई थी उनके बाद के बहुत टिपिकल तरह के कैरेक्टर मिल रहे थे मुझे. अगर किसी को टेररिस्ट की ज़रूरत होती थी तो मुझे कास्ट किया जाता था. अगर किसी को कोई सेंसिटिव पोइट की ज़रूरत होती थी तो मुझे अप्रोच किया जाता था. तो एक टेंडेंसी होती है आपको स्टीरियोटाइप करने की. मुझे लगता है वो बदल रही है. और आई थिंक इट आल्सो हैज़ टू डू विद द फैक्ट दैट आई हैव बीन पेशेंट. यू नो, आई हैवंट जंप्ड इनटू फिल्म आफ्टर फिल्म बिकॉज आई ऑलवेज थॉट इट वाज इंपॉर्टेंट टू हैव क्वालिटी ओवर क्वांटिटी. एंड आई थिंक दैट्स सॉर्ट ऑफ पेइंग ऑफ नाउ. सो या, आई फील लाइक एज एन एक्टर माई टाइम इज नाउ स्टार्टिंग. उफ ये कितना अब
ओके सुमित अब तक फिल्म आज हम देखने वाले हैं और अब तक आपने बॉलीवुड में किसी को दिखाई और क्या रिस्पांस रहा है
ये सबका अच्छा लगता है हिमांशु को हमने दिखाई थी फिल्म काफी अच्छी लगी और हमने और काफी लोगों को दिखाई काफी लोगों को दिखाई विक्रम अडवाणी सॉ द फिल्म ही आल्सो लव्ड इट अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हैव यू नो रियली अप्रिशिएटेड द फिल्म सो या सो फार रिस्पांस हैज बीन रियली गुड वी डिड अ स्क्रीनिंग एज वेल फॉर आवर ओन कास्ट एंड क्रू एंड आल्सो वी इनवाइटेड ऑब्वियसली आवर फ्रेंड्स एंड पीपल हु यू नो मैटर टू अस सो एवरीवन हैज बीन रियली लाइकिंग द फिल्म एंड स्पेशल परफॉर्मेंसेस बाय कृतिका एंड कुणाल एंड होपफुली यू गाइस विल आल्सो लाइक इट
ओके द लास्ट वन फ्रॉम माय एंड आई बिलीव समवन गोइंग टू आस्क यू what's the best compliment you got of the film both of you during the screening you know Tigmanchu came on board and he saw the film he appreciated it as he said aside
he just said मजा है like Tigmanchu says अच्छा मस्त है नहीं ऐसा कुछ नहीं हुआ कि कोई मतलब
हाँ मतलब
कोई बाहर आया और रोते हुए गले लगा लिया कि वाह क्या काम किया
था आदमी एक यू नो जब फिल्म मेकिंग की हम बात करते हैं जब दिग्मांशु से दिग्गज या कोई और फिल्म में हंसी आती है तो अपना एक पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू जरूर रखते हैं
जी एक्चुअली क्या होता है कि प्रीव्यूज में ज्यादातर कभी कभार होता है कि लोग आपको झूठ बोल देते हैं और कहते हैं कि अरे यार बहुत अच्छी पिक्चर है ऑल द बेस्ट बहुत मजा आया लेकिन लकीली हमारे दोस्तों ने देखी और वो ऐसे लोग हैं जो अगर उनको कुछ पसंद ना आए तो वो आपकी धज्जियां उड़ा देते हैं बोलते हैं क्या किया तुमने क्यों किया कैसी एक्टिंग किया या क्या डायरेक्शन किया तुमने तो उस तरह के दोस्त हैं हमारे लकीली तो उन सबको अच्छी लगी बहुत तो आई थिंक दैट इन इटसेल्फ वाज सैटिस्फाइंग इनफ फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस
आई थिंक द फिल्म लीव्स यू विद अ थॉट इन द एंड आई मीन व्हेन यू वॉच इट आपको पता चलेगा तो पीपल वर डिस्कसिंग इट यू नो लोग बाहर आए उन्होंने डिस्कस किया कि ऐसा क्यों हुआ ये होना चाहिए था नहीं होना चाहिए था सो आई थिंक दैट इज लाइक यू नो I think some sort of a victory कि people took it back home और उन्होंने उस चीज को discuss किया कि ऐसा क्यों हुआ you know so that involvement I think is the biggest compliment to the film
correct you will discuss it it's not a film जो शायद मतलब आप
हाँ मतलब आप देख के आप सोचेंगे कि
एक तो आप relate करेंगे भाई जो कि बहुत ही as कुणाल सर कृतिका सर की बहुत ही relatable film है characters बहुत relatable हैं और even the situation is very relatable कि how relationships break up and yet you want to be with each other That whole situation is very relatable and the characters are very relatable and even the how the film pans out you will discuss it कि यार ऐसा ही क्यों हुआ ऐसा क्यों नहीं हो सकता था
कि क्या किसने क्या सही किया किसने क्या गलत किया as characters
सही क्या है गलत क्या है
तो that question
correct
comes in
you will debate that
yeah
thank you
one more last question and then we proceed to the room okay
so anything you want to say to audience about the film
नहीं बस बोल चुके जो बोलना था मुझे लगता है बस जस्ट आई थिंक इट्स लाइक आई सेड इट्स अ फिल्म दैट इज डिफरेंट शॉर्ट फिल्म दैट इज इट्स वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट यू सीन बिफोर एंड आई एम श्योर दैट यू विल एंजॉय इट यू विल रिलेट टू इट एंड आई लव टू सी व्हाट द फीडबैक ऑफ पीपल इज
या इट्स डिफरेंट एंड येट इट्स वेरी रियल फॉर यू लाइक इट्स डिफरेंट एंड येट इट्स वेरी रिलेटेबल
थैंक यू सो मच
थैंक यू
थैंक यू सो मच थैंक यू फॉर जॉइनिंग अस टुडे Ladies and gentlemen, as we go ahead with this conference, Royal Stag Barrel Select Large Shop Films is definitely a very, very beautiful platform for all the aspiring directors who wants to showcase their creativity, who wants to showcase their artistic creativity in front of the world. Ladies and gentlemen, definitely this is a credible stage for all those amazing aspiring and inspiring storytellers who wants to showcase their work through the online medium to their target audience. And today we all are here gathered as we release the latest short film White Shirt directed by Mr. Sumit Arora. Before we go ahead and I ask all of you three to share your experiences, we would love to have to see the movie on the screen. So can I request the movie to be placed on the screen? I request also to have all your eyes at the screen here. Check. It's okay. You can check.
Well, hi guys. First of all, thank you so much for coming here and turning up and watching our film. I hope you enjoyed it. But it was a wonderful experience making the film, of course. What I really particularly enjoyed about the film was that in a world where there's a lot of short films nowadays, and I felt like the short films that are out there are always constantly trying to be really smart. You know, there's a twist in the end, trying to grab the audience's attention. But after a long time, I came across a script which I felt had a lot of heart, and a script where I felt like it was an intimate romantic drama, this kind of which I had not seen in the short film format. So for me, that was very, very interesting. And of course, the chance to work with such a wonderful actress, such a wonderful director, made it even more exciting. So I feel like this is a film that is very different in the short film format. Yet what I really like about it is that it's very relatable. You know, these are characters and situations that I think a lot of us have been through. And I think, you know, we've all been through a situation where the relationship is broken and it's over, but you try to hold on to whatever you can to keep that relationship alive. And that I felt like the metaphor of the white shirt and holding on to that was very, very interesting. So it's been wonderful, and I hope you guys enjoyed it.
Thank you, sir. Ma'am?
Hi, so you've pretty much said everything. It was a wonderful journey just doing this film, and when I heard the story also, I found it really relatable. We've all been in love, we've all been heartbroken, and I think we've all like learned to move on. So this is, you know, that whole curve. And of course, the association with Royal Stag Barrel Select Large Short Films has been great, because the kind of stories they've backed before this one are some of the best short films that have come out. And to really have a platform like this for a little film was great. So yeah, I really hope everybody enjoys, whoever watches the film enjoys it and is able to relate to the emotions that we've tried to play.
Hi, thank you so much for coming and watching the film. For me, the making of the short film has been a really liberating experience and exercise, because I used to write for the people, you know, do stuff for the people, and this was the first time I was doing something for myself. Like, you know, I was writing something, I was going to direct something on my own. So I decided that I will make the film which I really want to make, in the sense that I really want to tell the story that I really want to tell. And the story about, you know, a couple, like when you watch a love story, you're usually watching a broad stroke love story. You know, okay, this couple meets, this happens. I was always interested, I've always been more interested in the intimate details of a relationship. What happens between, what transpires between two people when they're together, when they are, you know, falling apart, what's really happening between them, those small details, you know, the small things like a white shirt, you know, just that white shirt, how it can really matter a lot, yet it's a tiny little thing. So I really want to explore that theme in terms of, you know, the intimacy of a couple and what happens when the love is lost, you know, and yet there is still something between them. The love is lost, but yet something is holding them together. So that was my area that I want to play with. And then I got to obviously work with Kunal and Kritika, and they got so much, you know, on the film, you know, so much of it on what you see obviously was there in the script. And then these two brought so much on the film, added so much to so much of value to the film. And then obviously, then once we made the film, we thought, okay, we have a good story in our hand. So I was looking for a platform to put this film on. And then I really looked around and thought, what is a platform that is really good for short films? And this Royal Stag, you know, Barrel Select Large Short Film was the only platform that came to my mind, because that we have seen Ahilya, we have seen Chutney, you know, such great films coming out of this platform. You know, there's only one platform which comes to your mind when you think of a short film, which was this. And I thought, this has to be this. And I'm really grateful that our film is going to come out on this platform.
Thank you so much, sir. Well, now we open the stage for the questions, and I request you all to kindly put your hands up, and one by one, we can go ahead with the questions.
बोला साहब के फर्स्ट शॉर्ट फिल्म है
जी,
तो क्या खास लगा आपने जिसे चूज किया आपने?
जी एक्चुअली मैं एक दो पहले कर चुका हूँ, बट उन फिल्मों को ऑब्वियसली इस तरह का प्लेटफॉर्म नहीं मिला जैसे लास्ट शॉर्ट फिल्म है. जैसा मैंने कहा, मुझे जो सबसे इंटरेस्टिंग बात इस पिक्चर की लगी कि बहुत देर बाद मुझे ऐसा लगा कि एक डायरेक्टर और एक लेखक ऐसी कहानी कहना चाहता है जो बहुत ही एक पर्सनल कहानी थी, बहुत इंटीमेट थी, रोमांटिक ड्रामा था. जबकि जब मैं शॉर्ट फिल्में देखता हूँ जो इंटरनेट पे है, जो रिलीज़ हो रही हैं, बहुत अच्छी अच्छी फिल्में रिलीज़ हो रही हैं, लेकिन देयर द जो जॉनर है वो बहुत अलग है. तो मुझे ये बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग लगा कि बहुत देर बाद एक पोइटिक सी एक कहानी कहने की कोशिश की जा रही है. और जो कैरेक्टर्स थे, चाहे वो अवीक का कैरेक्टर हो या कृतिका का कैरेक्टर हो, दोनों कैरेक्टर्स बहुत रिलेटेबल हैं, सिचुएशंस बहुत रिलेटेबल हैं. मुझे लगता है कि जब आपका दिल टूटता है या आप इधर यू हार्ट ब्रोकन और यू ब्रोकन समवनस हार्ट, आप कोशिश करते हैं कि अलग अलग तरीके से उस रिलेशनशिप को ज़िंदा रखें. तो इसमें वाइट शर्ट जो है वो मेटाफोर है. एक पहले तो रिलेशन ज़िंदा रखने की कोशिश है. दूसरा ये भी है कि एक रिलेशनशिप, जैसे वो सीन था व्हेन शी स्मेल्स द शर्ट, आई थॉट दैट वाज अ ब्यूटीफुल सीन, के जो रिलेशनशिप है वो अब बासी हो चुका है, उसमें एक इट्स टाइम टू मूव ऑन फ्रॉम दैट रिलेशनशिप, व्हिच इज़ एग्जैक्टली व्हाट शी डज. तो बहुत छोटी छोटी डिटेल्स थी जो स्क्रिप्ट में जो मुझे बहुत पसंद आई.
Hi, good afternoon. My question is for Kritika. You've done a lot of short films earlier also in your initial stages, and this is one of the most, I would say, short film which you managed to take the credit for in the last, actually. Since it's a relationship-based short film, you as a protagonist, you seem to walk off and start your life afresh. Yeah. Being a female protagonist in your personal life, what do you feel are the things which a woman or a lady should be careful of to make sure that the relationship moves smoothly?
I think not
on
just
a personal level. Yeah.
Yeah, on a personal level, I'm telling you, I'm actually not like this character at all. I am not. Of course, my relationship matters a lot to me, but I don't think I rest everything on it. Everything does not depend on it. But here, you know, Vani was somebody who held it so close, who was so dependent on the man in her life, that it was difficult for her to move on. Not saying that it's not difficult for me or anybody else, but not just for a girl, for anybody. I think, you know, some things when it was just about, it was a sort of a liberation in the end, which is why you think that it's the character that sort of like moves on, and that's why you think that she's sort of, you know, walked away from, and she has. I don't know if it was the right thing to do or not, or what did, you know, should they have gotten back together? Should she really, I mean, is it right that she walked off? I don't know. That's something that everybody will sort of have an opinion on. But in real life, I think if something is over, if something is not, you know,
moving the way you want to.
Yeah, not serving its purpose anymore in your life, then you need to be strong and you need to move on. A lot of women I see are trapped in relationships. This is not like this relationship, but a lot of, when they're not happy, but they're still doing it because of, say, a societal pressure, or because, you know, I think they're so invested. But yeah, moving on is beautiful in its own way. And whether you're a girl or a boy, when it's over, you know, have to sort of sometimes.
But as a woman, once you get into a relationship and you move on, how easy or difficult is it from a woman's perspective to not make the same mistakes, or at the same time not close the barriers?
Definitely. I think I have learned a lot from all my relationships, you know, not just romantic ones, but with other people as well. So when things don't go well, you have to be strong enough to walk away and then make sure you don't make the same mistakes.
So what are the common mistakes you feel you would not make in your new relationships?
You know, that we'll keep for some other time when we talk about me.
Okay. Sumit, a fantastic approach to the entire film. The cinematic appeal, the production values, everything was perfect. Do you feel that the character of Vani could have been shown as a more stronger person from the initial stages? Like, you show her, she's slightly confused. She's not sure. That's true. Fine. But the end itself is still a bit, you know, it leaves a lot of doubts in people's minds. So was that a concerted effort towards the ending of the film?
Yeah, if Vani was a strong person, then the end wouldn't work at all. Because if she was strong, she already has the courage and the power and the strength to really walk out of a relationship which is not working for her personally. The whole arc is of a weak woman character, female character, who finds courage, who learns to live on her own. You know, that's the arc.
Yeah.
So Kunal, yeah, Kunal and Kritika, congratulations to you guys
Thank you.
For your chemistry and for the work you have done. Firstly, I would appreciate your words about the short films you said. I just want to know that is it the transformation from the feature films to the short films because the feature films don't get the proper way, the proper kind of distribution? They just get the problem in distribution. Is it the reason that feature films are being facing the hindrance in comparison to short films?
No, I don't think it's that. I think, as an actor or as a filmmaker or producer, it's great that we have more and more platforms to distribute our work. Film, of course, is one platform. Television is another. The short stories and the digital medium is the third platform. And it's great that there's more and more platforms opening up. I don't think it's one against the other. I think it's, you can be part of all the platforms at the same time. And I think what is great about short films is it gives you as an actor and a director a chance to experiment. It also gives you a chance to tell stories that would not fit into a longer format. Sometimes you have a story which is a great idea, but it doesn't make a 1 hour, 20 minute or 2 hour compelling enough film because it's not such a large idea that you can extend for so long, but it makes a great short film. So it gives you a chance to experiment and put that idea out there. So I think as an actor and as a director, as a producer, I think it's great that more and more platforms are available. And really, I don't think it's one against the other. I think it's, they all support each other.
Kritika, do you think that the short films provide you the equal amount of exposure as the feature films?
Yes, absolutely. I think the digital medium is huge. I think the internet, the fact that you can watch this film on your phone, you can't really watch a 2.5 hour film on your phone as opposed to a short film like this. See, it's like a novel and short stories. So if the story is only that much, then you can't stretch it. I mean, this stretched to a 2.5 hour film would not really, work. So it's just that difference. I don't think there's any other difference. And when it's this length, you can't really have a theater release. So it's the digital medium, which is huge.
Thank you.
कुणाल, जैसे आपने अंदर कहा, वेल टेकिंग योर इंटरव्यू सेट कि मेरे हमारे दोस्तों ने फिल्में देखी और उन्होंने बहुत हॉनेस्ट जवाब दिया कि उन्हें किस तरह की फिल्में की क्रिटिसाइज भी किया. मैं भी उन्हीं दोस्तों की तरह कुछ कहना चाहूँगा. एंड की अगर मैं बात करूँ, इवन टू द डायरेक्टर, माई क्वेश्चन इफ यू कैन हियर मी, दिस मच बेटर. एंड अगर मैं फिल्म की एंडिंग की बात करूँ, जहाँ पर वो वाणी का किरदार छोड़ के चला जाता है, क्या ये जस्टिफाई है छोड़ के जाना? एक तरफ इट इज़ शोन शी इज़ इन लव विथ दैट गाय, फिर उसके बावजूद उसको छोड़, हालांकि पूरी की पूरी फिल्म में लड़का ही झुका हुआ है, वही सॉरी बोल रहा है, वही फ़ोन कर रहा है, वही मनाने की कोशिश कर रहा है, लड़की हमेशा की तरह वही अटपटे जवाब, अच्छा क्यों फ़ोन किया, अच्छा ठीक है रख रही हूँ, तो एंड I'm not happy with the end. Why you felt so, the director and the actor?
I think it's very good that you're not happy with the end, because half the people are happy with the end, half the people are not. And I think that is what makes a good film, is when you come out of the film and you have an argument about, nahi yaar ye hona chahiye tha, koi aur bolega nahi yaar mujhe to lagta hai ye hona chahiye tha. So I think that is what makes an interesting film, is when people have different perspectives on it. So you might not be happy with the end. When I read the script, I thought it was a great end, because I felt like it was about time that she moved on. It was a relationship, like she said, that it served its purpose, and it was a relationship that wasn't what it started off being. It had changed, the relationship, so she needed to move on. So I thought it was a good ending, but it's great that we can both sit here and argue about it, and I think that's what makes a good film.
ओके, टू द डायरेक्टर, क्यों, मतलब वजह क्या वजह? एक तरफ तो दिखा रहे हैं, जो अगर मैं फिल्म की बात करूं, दिखता है कि भाई द गाय इज रियली इन लव विद दैट गर्ल, इवन दैट गर्ल रिस्पॉन्ड इन द सेम वे, वेदर शी इज स्लीपिंग विद द शर्ट एंड ऑल.
पर्सनली फील, आई डोंट नो इफ आई एम रॉन्ग, यू प्रोबेबली हैव मिस्ड अ इंपॉर्टेंट बीट इन द फिल्म, वेयर ही पुट्स द वेयर शी टेक्स द परफ्यूम बॉटल आउट ऑफ अ बैग एंड शी कीप्स इट इन फ्रंट एंड ही सेज के वो बस एक प्रोजेक्ट के लिए घर पर आई थी. And she says, you have told me this many times before, you promised me that you won't meet her again. This guy is cheating on her, Avik is cheating on her, but yet he loves her, There are two kind of, there's one character who you make someone into a completely asshole, who's like this guy who constantly cheats on a woman, but he's not really like that. He's a good guy, but yet he's weak, he's flawed, So he's a flawed character. So this, so Vani has reasons to, you know, really move out of the relationship. It's not like everything is not, you know, hunky-dory in the relationship. It's a relationship which is now falling apart. So she has the rights to move on.
And I don't think it's just, and she also says ki main tumhe maaf nahi kar pa rahi hu, you know. So I'm sure ye
maaf nahi kar pa rahi hu lekin pyar bhi kar rahi hu.
That's how it is.
You love the person, but she's not able to forgive him. So if she can't forgive him, then she's so
mahan.
Mahan ho ki wo maaf kar de. Ya ye galti nahi hui hoti. So it's not that, it's not just that he's the male character is flawed. It's also usse galti agar hui hai. Usse galti hui hai. He's not a bad guy. He didn't.
Yeah,
you know, uski intention nahi thi, but usse galti hui hai. But isse wo maaf, she can't forgive it. So fir kya fayda? It's like that.
Okay,
and you're not happy with it, but I want a girl's perspective also.
Yeah, that would be interesting to see a girl's point of view on that.
Because after the screening also, kafi ladke khush nahi the with the ending, but ladkiyan theek thi.
Okay, Kunal, let me know the percentage people who are not happy with the ending.
Sorry?
The people who have already seen the film,
yehi ho raha tha. Some people were happy, some people were not happy. Kuch logon ko laga ki usne theek
kiya. And that's the beauty of it, right? To have an argument on that.
Yeah.
I mean, I would really, as she's saying, we would really live to have a female point of view on the whole thing. See, that's a point of view.
Why are you looking at me? No.
Let's not get into that right now. Right.
Okay, Sumit. As per a female...
But why men? It applies to women as well. It's men and women. I mean, it's not like only men cheat in relationships and women don't cheat in relationships. I don't think it's a
gender-specific thing.
I think it applies to both, and it comes down to how much you value the commitment that you have and you've made to somebody. So,
okay, Sumit, as per a female point of view, jo pura end tha, for me it was not good because... अगर मैं स्ट्रॉन्ग माइंडेड लड़की हूँ तो स्टार्टिंग में ही मैं वो शर्ट को डस्टबिन में डाल देती ओके जस्ट गो अवे लाइक उसको इतना मैं स्ट्रेच नहीं करती कि मैं रिलेशनशिप के अंदर अपने
बट वो स्ट्रॉन्ग माइंडेड नहीं है
मेंटली
बट वो स्ट्रॉन्ग माइंडेड नहीं है
नो बट ऑन स्क्रीन द गर्ल इज शोइंग कि शी इज अ स्ट्रॉन्ग माइंडेड गर्ल एंड इंडिपेंडेंट
व्हेन
ऑलवेज थ्रू आउट द मूवी या
शी She's struggling with it. If she was strong, she would probably just, as you're saying, wo shirt ko utha ke fek deti. If she was strong in the beginning.
Right.
So she is keeping the shirt. He calls her. She doesn't call him ever. It's the first time she called in the end. And he says, ki, how did you call for the first time? If she was strong, she would have, as you said, ki, wo ja ke shirt ko fek deti. Ya pehle scene mein ja ke bolti ki, yaar, main tumhare shirt ko तुम्हारे वॉचमैन के पास तुम्हारे ऑफिस में जाके छोड़ के जा रही हूँ तुम ले लेना तुम्हें जिसे लेना तुम ले लेना शर्ट को बट वो नहीं कर पाती है ये यू नो
एंड ऑल्सो आई डोंट थिंक रिलेशनशिप्स इन लाइफ हैव अ स्ट्रक्चर
या
इट्स नॉट ब्लैक एंड वाइट की रिलेशन अगर पर्सन ऐसा है तो ये ऐसा ही करेगा आई थिंक रिलेशनशिप्स आर मैटर्स ऑफ द हार्ट एंड यू नो देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ ग्रे एरियाज दैट रिलेशनशिप्स ट्रेड इन एंड समटाइम्स यू कुड बी अ स्ट्रॉन्ग पर्सन बट रिएक्ट इन अ सर्टेन वे इन अ रिलेशनशिप और यू कुड बी अ वीक पर्सन बट यू कुड फाइंड स्ट्रेंथ इन अ रिलेशनशिप So I don't think relationships are mathematics. You know what I mean?
Correct.
Ke a person will react like this because their personality is like that.
And it's not just about ki strong woman or weak woman. Sometimes you're so invested in a relationship, you can't fall out of love in a day, na? Ki agar ye ho gaya hai, to aisa nahi hai. So they give it. He's also trying. I think sometimes she's also not able to. She's sleeping with the shirt. She's living with the shirt. She's not able to move on. But then she decides to move on. So even if even if it was reversed. अगर वो लड़का भी होता तो भी शायद इतना टाइम तो लगता है ना हाउ डू यू फॉल आउट ऑफ लव इन अ डे और व्हाटएवर यू नो यू कांट सो इट्स
सो एज अ व्यूअर द स्टोरी इज इनकम्प्लीट फॉर मी फॉर द एंडिंग लाइक अचानक से एंड में व्हाट मेड हर टू रिटर्न द शर्ट एंड जस्ट वॉक अवे
यू नो दैट पॉइंट व्हेन शी व्हेन द मेड मेक्स अ रियलाइज कि आपकी ये कितनी बाकी बदबू आ रही है आप इसके साथ सोते कैसे हो टिल देन शी इज नॉट इवन रियलाइज देन शी smells it and she realizes that yeah maybe this relationship is dead so like he said the white shirt is a metaphor so maybe it is dead ye shayad ye this is over but I need to now let go of it
okay,
I think lastly, that is the turning point
lastly Sumit kab upload ho raha hai for the viewers
aaj 7:30 baje sham ko एंड ऑल्सो टू जस्ट गिव यू टू एड टू वॉट कृतिका सेड, यू नो के जब मेड उसको बोलती है, और अक्सर ऐसा लाइफ में होता है कि आपने अगर कोई शर्ट पहन रखी है चार दिन से तो आपको उसकी बदबू नहीं मालूम पड़ेगी इतना, लेकिन कोई और आपके पास आएगा और बोलेगा यार यू आर स्टिंकिंग, एंड यू लाइक हाँ यार ओ बदबू आ रही है शर्ट से, तो क्योंकि आप जिस चीज़ के साथ रहने के आदी हो जाते हो आपको उसकी क्वालिटीज, उसकी बदबू या उसकी खुशबू का फर्क पड़ना बंद हो जाता है, लेकिन कोई थर्ड पार्टी अगर आपको बोलती है आपको रियलाइज होता है कि ओ यस यू नो ये एक्चुअली शर्ट बदबू मार रही है, शर्ट एक्चुअली खत्म हो चुका है और मुझे निकल जाना चाहिए इसमें से बाहर।
हेलो सर, सुमित सर, हेलो मैम,
नहीं मतलब सी दैट्स अ मेटाफर।
हेलो सर, हेलो मैम, कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन फॉर शॉर्ट फिल्म सर, यंगस्टर के लिए तो ये बहुत चीज सीख मिलेगी सर, और सर से एक क्वेश्चन है सर, सर अगर आपको सेकेंड चांस मिला होता तो सर आप क्या करते हैं सर, अगर सपोज पैचअप
तो फिर हम पार्ट टू बनाते।
ओह ग्रेट सर,
सर यार मैंने तो लिखी नहीं है, उन्होंने लिखी है, तो आप उनको पूछिए वो क्या करते हैं पार्ट टू में।
ही वुड हैव मेड इट वर्क।
ओके सर,
अभी वुड हैव मेड इट, ही वुड हैव गॉटन बेटर प्रोबेबली।
My question to Sumit sir and Kunal sir, apart from digital platform, is there any scope or you know opportunity to screen this film on multiplexes? Because there are a lot of films like Kriti, Auj, there are many filmmakers are coming and they are making short films. So is there any scope or you know, in future chances they will be screened on multiplexes? You might be getting you know screens apart from digital platform for large short films.
I don't know, yaar. Wo to मालूम पड़ेगा आगे जाकर ही, अगर लास्ट शॉर्ट फिल्म डिसाइड करता है कि वो यू नो अपनी पूरी कलेक्शन बनाकर दे वांट टू डू अ स्क्रीन, दे वांट टू डू अ मल्टीप्लेक्स रिलीज, दे कैन।
सो
फीचर ऑफ दिस फिल्म और फिल्म एट लार्ज यू सी शॉर्ट फिल्म्स? हाँ यार काफ़ी होता भी है, देर आर क्वाइट अ लॉट ऑफ फिल्म जहाँ पे कई लोग शॉर्ट फिल्म्स को मिलाकर एक साथ यू नो पांच छह फिल्मों को मिलाकर दे डू अ रिलीज प्रॉपर्ली, सो या इट्स पॉसिबल।
सो मिस्टर सुमित, बीइंग द कैप्टन ऑफ द शिप, इट्स क्वाइट अप्रिशिएबल व्हेन यू से दैट यू प्रोवाइड द रूम फॉर आर्गुमेंट बिटवीन दोज हु लाइक और दोज हु डोंट लाइक, सो डू यू थिंक दैट देयर इज अ अपॉर्चुनिटी और देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन अराइजेस दैट बिफोर मेकिंग अ मूवी यू कैन थ्रो अ सर्वे दैट what sort of ending people will like and you will just make according to that. Although that kills the creativity.
Last question.
I think release ke baad apne aap survey ho jayega yaar. Wo apne aap reaction se malum pad jayega kitne logo.
Sumit sir, yeah. Here. Was there a metaphor behind the potato biryani also?
No, it was just something that she liked.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you everyone. We'll have photo ops now. And for